We now have the pleasure to listen to Mr. Vidal from the Polytechnic University of Valencia, where he is a professor of computer sciences. His main research topics are pattern recognition, multimodal interaction, handwritten text recognition, and human language technology. The floor is yours.
Well, my topic is about searching information in handwriting documents. So the title that you have in the program is very long, so I have made it shorter here. And it is an official title, but let's keep this one, which is more informative, I think. So the talk is mainly based on some demonstration that are in point two. So I briefly introduce the problem I am going to talk about. Then I go to the demonstrations, and after the demonstration, I will show how it works. That is to say, what is the technology behind the things that you have, that you will see in the demonstration. And then in the end, there will be some conclusion. So, handwritten text image indexing and search. So there are many huge image collections in archives and libraries, thousands of terabytes of image data already stored in many places. But the really interesting information which is contained in these images is still practically inaccessible, because you only have the images. So if you want to find some information in some, let's say, 1 million images collection, then you cannot go through one by one through the collection to find the thing you are looking for. Of course, if we could transcribe perfectly, or at least sufficiently with sufficient accuracy, the million images, let's say, then we could use standard indexing and searching technology, like is being used for instance, by Google, for the books that are processed by OCR. So OCR provides sufficiently precise transcripts, and then as far as all you can index the transcripts and then try to find the information. But for handwriting text recognition, and in particular for the kind of handwriting we are most interested in, the current results of automatic handwriting text recognition, automatic transcription, are still far from providing sufficient accuracy to deal with this job. In fact, maybe the accuracy will never be, I'm sure the accuracy will never be as high as with OCR, and then we will always be lacking accuracy in order to implement searching based on transcription, automatic transcription. Of course, we could do manual transcription, or we could do computer-assisted transcription, in order to alleviate the effort, the human effort needed for transcription. But that, for the kind of massive collections I am thinking about, that is also prohibited. No, it goes without saying that we will never transcribe, I don't know, maybe the Danish time machine collection will never be fully transcribed and checked manually or correctly. So that is out of question. And many other collections, like the Spanish Archivo de Indias, it also tens of kilometers, I think it's 40 kilometers itself. And it's quite interesting, and there are precious information hidden inside this collection that will never be accessible by transcription. So the good news that I'm going to talk about is that now we can really search for the information in the images without explicitly transcribing the images, without explicitly finding the text that is contained in the images. So the idea is the user wants to find a word of a sequence of words or something, and then the query is expressed in textual form, like you would do in with Google or something, and then the system will find the information in the images themselves without any previous transcription of the content of the images. So the demo, the demonstration that I'm going to show you, assume that the information is indexed at the text block level, is to say, the system will be able to find the text blocks where the words you are looking for are probably are. And I said the word, the fundamental word is probably are, because the search will not be exact searching, as you are using from Google and similar things, but the thing is carried out with a confidence threshold with that the user can specify in order to meet the required precision recall trigger. That is to say, to specify whether he wants to find places in the collection where the word he or she is looking for exactly is, or he prefers to have false alarms and then find all the places in the collection where the word may appear. For the technology that I will talk later, the word confidence scores are based on pixel level probabilities, but these pixel level probabilities are combined somehow in order to produce a probabilistic index at the block and the text block level, typically a page or a line, typically a page. The position of the spotted words are not explicitly obtained by the system, but then some approximation of the place where the word is located within the text block is available, and then it will be shown in the demonstration. I will show a demonstration with two tasks. In fact, there are four, but I will focus mainly on Benham. Benham is 18th and 19th century writing from several hands, and the system is trained, all the approach is based on machine learning, so the system needs to be trained, and for training this system we use 400 pages, transcribed pages of the collection, and with that we are able to search in the rest of the collection of the systems. The demonstration will be shown with just a small batch for the full collection, composed of 83 bases. Then I will show also another demonstration with Spanish writing, which is called Plantas. It's a botanic specimen book composed of 7 volumes. In this case, the system, well, this is 17th century writing, a single hand. So in this case, we needed less training, just 200 more pages. From volume 1 of this collection, with that we indexed the full volume 7 of the collection without any training or transcripts or anything, just fully automatic. I will show also preliminary tests with an extension of these ideas to allow for approximate search, to find words that are not indexed and then you find by approximation. And then also for multi-word queries in order to express Boolean combination, like you want to find pages where several words appear all at the same time in the page, or you want to find a string of words. We are working on that, but we can show you how it will work in some years or maybe in some months. This is just a demonstration. It's not yet intended for real operation, but there are no tricks. And in fact, there is a web page that should be right up here, but if not, you'll see in the browser where you can try yourself all these things. So I'm going to switch to the demonstration now. So this is because of there were network problems in order to connect to the server and to the real demonstration. I have a server here in my laptop. So you can also see that there are not huge computational power needed, because everything will run in the laptop right now. But for the second part of the demonstration, I will switch to the real place where you can also play yourself. Maybe I can show you first of all the place so that you can play while I am there. So, It is under the Transcriptorium web page, and this one. So this Transcriptorium, demo TS, TS is for Transcriptorium, and then KWS, keyword spotting. You put that in your browser and you can try to do the same thing that I'm going to do now locally. I'm going to read locally. We have several collections. This is a sample of the collection we have indexed. But to start with, I will focus on the Benham collection. As I said, Benham collection is composed of two batches. By the way, the search is hierarchical, so that you first find the collection, then you find the batch or the chapter or the book within the collection, then the chapter within the book, and so on. In this demonstration, only this one has two levels. It was the chapter or the batch level and then the page level. Okay. So I can start looking. Another thing is, here you have the place to specify the compromise between precision and recall that you wish. Now it is set to 50%, which is, let's say, the standard default value. And you can also express the precision recall you wish by saying how many hits or how many instances you want to obtain as a result. Or you can use both things. This limits the hits you find with this. I keep this unused for the moment. And I can try to find here one of the interesting words in the Benham writing, which is panopticon. Panopticon is his concept of an ideal prison. This was a philosopher and general writer in England, and then he wrote a lot about prisons and prisoners and how to handle all these things. And so he introduced the concept of panopticon, which was the ideal prison. And then I get three pages in the first batch and one page in the second. So I can go to the first batch. Here, this is the three pages. I go like one by one. By the way, this bar in the bottom is the confidence level with which the work has been found in this page. In this case, it's 100%. It's very, very confident. This is a long word, and it's easy to find, typically. So, let me go to the other one. In the second part, there is one page here, also with 100% confidence. So here you have one of the instances. The sisters found the page, but within the page, we try to find approximately the position of the word. In this case, it's very accurate. But not always is so accurate. This is another instance of panopticon. Yet another with a different hand. More difficult, but still very accurate. And still another one here. Okay. Now, I'm going to search for some more difficult things, like more common words like offense. In this case, I find six pages in the first batch and 10 in the second. Let's explore first the first batch. Most of them are high confidence. This one is a little bit lower, and this one is a little bit lower. So let's see all of them. So. So this one is the lowest confidence. I'm going to open it here. And in fact, this offense. Okay. This one, another, yet another, 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 and another. Some of them are not trivial, but the system do find all. In the second batch there are plenty of offenses, the text is a lot of things about this. So let's put some very low. The confidence here is 52%, just above the threshold. So I can see this one. Oh, here you have also your offense. Well, in fact, this is it is lower confidence because the, technically speaking, this is not a correct hit because it, the word, the real word, plural. So, but as you can find offense with some lower confidence, and that would be useful in this. Okay. So this is for the easy things. You can try to find more difficult words like a fact, which is short and it can be confused with fact. And many other possible confusions, but again, as you will see, the accuracy is high. We have four matches in the third batch. So, one after the other, and then in the second batch there are four. By the way, the color of the bounding, of the line bounding box is related with the confidence with which the word has been found in the images. In this case, you have your fact here, okay? Here you have fact, then are two instances of the word in this page. This is a false alarm. This is not fact, okay? The fat, and of course you can get rid of this false alarm by increasing the confidence threshold, but in that case you lose recall. Yes, there will be some instances that there will not be one false alarm. Again, you have fat and fat, two instances, and last also fat. And sure, there is the word facts. So we can try to express a bit the system and try to find facts in plural. So there are no plenty. Just one page with one instance. Here you have your facts. Okay. Yes?
Would it find the word fact if it's in the middle of a longer word, like old factory or something?
As I will explain later, the system is based on a recognizer that takes into account the lexical and language context. So in this way, we are able to find the real words and not the strings that the. Of course, if you lower the confidence threshold, then you can find these things. And also, you can use approximate search as a good player. Okay? So, I'm sure there are more facts. So, in order to find them, I should lower the confidence somehow, maybe 2%. But not here. Something like that. So, there are many more. But probably they are false alarms. Okay, we'll see. Taking into account that I have lowered the threshold significantly, and so I am trying to find everything at the expenses of having to see false alarms. Let's see the false alarm because the real hits. This is four, not fact. Look at the color is reddish, which is means lower confidence. It has nothing to do with fact. This is extra false alarm. So here you have some facts. Okay. So we found one. That was hidden. It has 35% confidence. Okay. And here, I think it's facts again. No. is fact, comma. this is with an S. And this was the previous one. So this is more or less all about Bentham. Then I go to the other collection I wanted to show you, which is Plantas. It contains more than 700 pages that are completely untranscribed and belong to a volume that has never been seen by the recognition or by the humans or by nobody. So only the machine has seen this. Well, of course, there are people interested that have been looking. You see this, and that's all the pages. You have an idea of the size. Okay. Now for Plantas, I can show this. The first volume of Plantas was about grain, and the seventh volume is about legumes. So in this case, the lexicon for indexing has been incremented with respect to the lexicon seen in the third volume by adding the glossary of this book that was transcribed manually, the glossary, which was the names of the plants that appear in this volume and not in the previous volume. So in total, in this case, I think the vocabulary was about 20,000 words, polygon, that are indexed, all of them are indexed. And here I can try to find one of the most popular legumes, which is in Spanish is haba, in plural habas. Haba is bean in general, and there are many different kinds of habas. In modern Spanish, haba is a specific kind of bean, but at the time, every bean was called an haba. So I get 33 matches with 50% confidence. Let's have a look at some of those which are not high confidence. This one. There's a picture here. let's see what you have. Okay. Here you have your abas. As I said, the exact place where the word is only obtained approximately, and so it's not the system does not was not developed for finding the exact position. It's just allowing the user to find the word. Okay. Here we have two matches, here and here. Here more difficult, but again, here you have your... Others. Here is lower confidence, it's yellow, but it's because the author here uses a variation of the word with lower B rather than higher B, a long B. But again, it finds with lower confidence that it finds it. There you have your Abbas, nice illustration. And here you have your. And here is a false alarm. Okay, this is bubas, not abas. This is a false alarm. Okay, this is what you get for a relatively easy word. Well, it's not that easy because it's short and it can be confused with other. So now I have prepared another word which is interesting. Is this book is written in Spanish, but is was written with an I mean to be encyclopedic, that is to say, to contain the whole knowledge about plants that was available at this time in the world. And so it has words in many languages, not only in Spanish, but it has also many words, like, for instance, one that I have chosen here in German is Kraut. It's also not too easy because it's very short, so we can see what happened with Kraut. So there are not many. And this one. And here you have ancient kraut. You don't know what is that, but maybe you know. And again, ancient kraut. Look at this kraut, which is difficult to spot because look like different words. And two instances of kraut in this last book may seem too little. So I can try to find more by lowering the confidence. And how here I have three matches, I am going to lower it more. Four matches. Okay, let's see if these four matches. The two new ones are these two, sorry. This and this, because the other two were high confidence. They are already, we have already seen them. This is one, and this is the other. Again, this is San Christopher Kraut, that is a name given by Los Alemanes, which is the Germans in Spanish. Okay. And also Sutter Kraut, which I think is sort of, you know, and of course you can try to find in this book other words that are not related with plants. You can try to find cities or countries. For instance, you can look for Austria or for Gunther. And then I found Austria is, well, let me increase the confidence. With high confidence, there is one Austria. It is here, related with Bohemia. Or if I lower the confidence a little bit, I find more. Probably with plenty of false alarms. So this one, for instance. And not Austria, okay, etc. Or you can try to find things like Flanders, which was the name given at the time for Holland and the Netherlands and Belgium. Yes, this is the confidence. So there are plenty of pages with this information. And this is a false alarm. Okay. So it is lower confidence. Let's see at this one. And there you have Flanders. Okay, this is what can be done already with the technology that I'm going to explain in the next part of the talk. I wanted to show you the approximate sheets and the multi-word sheets, but I can skip that, and then I explain a little bit how it works, because maybe you're curious about how it works. As I said, the idea is that we compute a confidence measure at the pixel level. So for every pixel, we compute the probability that this pixel belongs to a small region that contains the word we are looking for. In this case, we are looking for matter. And so we have these three peaks. This corresponds to this matter which is very fine and difficult to spot. And here is not matter, it's matter in plural, and you have a low confidence. You have low probability. The reason why we can do that is because in order to compute these pixel level probabilities, we rely on a recognizer that is context dependent, that is to say a recognizer that knows a lexicon and a language model. This is why the recognizer provides low confidence for things like it matter or matter not, but it's high for the matter or the matter of, which are very frequent in English, and so this is why this is boosted and this is lower. And this, which is difficult, is also gains a lot of probability thanks to the context. The matter or matter of are very good context for the word matter, and this is why this is. So once you have this probability map, then you have to combine all the probabilities into a single measure for each word in each ratio. Let's say the ratio is the case, for each case you need to compute for each of the words you want to index. What is the probability that this word appears in that page? And that is the more technical part of this thing that I know is not going to comment. Here are some laboratory results. Four collections that for three collections, Austen. Austen is a set of manuscripts of Shane Austen that are untranscribed. Well, they have been recently transcribed, but we got the original message without transcription. And then we started by training an indexing system with the models that we have from the Benham collection. And with the models obtained from the Benham collection, we trained we indexed the manuscripts of Austen. And so this is the worst result, which is this one. But this is the worst result, but it is still very good and very, very useful for finding information. So these cards are called the precision recall cards. The ideal situation would be a card like this, going to the corner and down here. So as close you are to the corner, it's better. There's less false alarms and more coherence or recall. Okay. So for all the collections, the results are very good. And also you can try to index things without any training by using the models from other collections. About multi-word queries and approximate search. For approximate search is needed for non-indexed words. Even if you index a large vocabulary like 20,000 or 50,000 words, in the end there will be some user that will insist in finding a word that is not in the lexicon. So you need for some approximation for non-indexed words. So the good news is that due to the probabilistic nature of the proposed table plotting confidence scores, which are based on the posterior probabilities that I have explained before, this becomes relatively easy because in the end it boils down to accumulating the probabilities of the confidences of similar words that are in the lexicon, that are indexed. And then this can, at query time, you can do this computation quickly and spotting the words that were not indexed. You also need approximations when you want to find, for instance, plurals and things like that without having to explicitly write the singular and the plural. You can insist or tell the system that do approximations, then they're writing, I don't know, prision and prisions. You can write precision approximate and then it finds all the approximations. All this becomes easy thanks to the probabilistic nature of the scores. Also for multi-word queries, Boolean and or not multi-word combination of probabilistic confidence is easy once you have the scores properly normalized and with a probabilistic interpretation. Then you have a probabilistic framework to obtain to compute good approximation to this kind of combination. So it becomes very easy to obtain to do Boolean combination of query words. And also you can rely on the AND combination in order to find word sequences. For that purpose you do an AND query for the words you want to find the sequence and then filter the results from the position of the bounding boxes that you find in the way you can find okay. And finally, conclusion. Well, my conclusion is here in blue, and here you have the place where you find the most recent. Fully automatic indexing, very large collections is now becoming perfectly feasible without a significant bottleneck about training and these things. So it is becoming a practical result. And you can play yourself with the demonstrators here. But where we are working now, we are trying to conclude the development of the new things, which are the multi-word and full text, multi-word and also strings of words, etc. And also trying to overcome the line detection bottleneck, which for all the demos that I have shown are based on a previous line detection of all the lines in the document. Now we are also working on the posterior probability map that I have shown before. We are working in removing the need for line segmentation altogether and trying to index the words directly at the page level, at the image level, which is you don't need any layout analysis or any line segmentation. But this is future work to be done in this. Okay? And that's all.